I'm Alex Williams, enterprise writer with TechCrunch, here with Robert Scoble wearing his Google Glass.
Yeah. All right. And my new Scotty vest. Come on.
What's the deal with the vest?
I got an iPad.
Oh, sweet. I mean, this is the kind of clothing you're going to need.
Got a Mophie in my pocket.
No, you wear that in the shower too?
No.
I wonder what you thought about the conference. I mean, the keynote today. Where were some of the high points for you that you saw?
For me, I'm writing a book on context, so I'm listening for things that are contextual or assistive. You know, so seeing some of the improvements in Google Now or the APIs that they just released around geolocation and context. Most people didn't catch them, but they have a new API that they can tell for context whether you're walking, running.
Driving the algorithm.
And that's just the start. Yeah. I expect that someday soon we're going to have a contextual OS that's going to tell developers what the user's doing. And that'll let you.
Why would we need a contextual
OS? To do what Larry Page said, which is turn off my glass in certain contexts, like in a meeting context, turn off certain notifications. Or augment what I'm trying to do. If I'm shopping, okay, that's where I actually want to see my to-do list, my shopping to-do list. Or if I'm riding on my bike, I don't want to see anything except maybe my heart rate and the map ahead, right? I don't want to see anything else. If I'm skiing, that's a different context than biking. I'm going to need different kinds of information, maybe snow, maybe weather, maybe what's the best trail to go down. Where are my friends? Recon over here at Google I.O. has a ski goggle that they make for Oakley, and it already does some of that.
So that kind of sets up a new world of multiple realities, yeah. Where we're, it's not just man, but it's man and data and all the kind of realities that go with that.
Yeah, no, it's a crazy future coming at us pretty fast. Yeah.
What'd you think of Larry?
Larry's smart, and I like when they do that, when they just answer everybody's questions and stand up there and don't be so damn scripted, but it seemed like filler because they didn't really have a full-on product announcement today. So I was like, "Where's anything about Google Glass? Where's the Android announcement? What, they're not announcing anything for Android, future."
Yeah. Why? Why?
Because they're on top of the world. Part of it is they don't need to right now, but part of it is the Glass has so much PR momentum around the world that you don't need to apply any gas to that. So wait until next year when you actually have something to ship. And Android is an interesting one. What is going on with the Android team? It seems like the team got rebuilt a bit. So maybe they just didn't have time to come out with a major new effort, and they want to, maybe make an announcement later. But it is strange.
It seems like a far more developer-oriented event. I mean, because in years past,
that's what it should be, right?
Yeah, in years past, there's a lot of hype around Google Glass, a lot of hype around Google Plus. This year, you heard a lot of excitement about the translation API, for instance.
Yeah. I like the voice, the voice search. Saying "Okay, okay, Google," and then being able to just talk to your computer. Those of us with Google Glass already understand what that's all about, because we already have "Okay, Glass," and we can just talk to it. We can say "Google." Alex Williams, and all of a sudden the information comes back, or Google Sushi in San Francisco, and places come by and we can do things. I like the photos. The voice search was really interesting, but I'd already seen that because of Glass. The photo edits were pretty interesting. It really seems like here they went after a few existing companies. They went after Spotify with the radio thing, right? With the play music. They went after, who else would they have gone after? They've gone after Spotify.
They went after a lot of startups that are kind of trying to build new services work across multiple forms.
My mind just went in a vapor lock there, but there was several.
Android Studio, I think, is...
Eclipse.
Yeah.
Wait a second. We're not using Eclipse anymore? We're going to have a new environment?
That's big.
New video codecs, which doesn't take on anybody. Oh, man, I'm...
What's interesting to me...
The photos thing goes after Adobe, right?
Yeah.
Why, straight on, why do you need Photoshop again?
Why
do you need to be Trey Ratcliffe and really understand how to do tone mapping and photomatics and all that stuff? Oh, just stick your photo in Google Plus and hit adjust and boom, it does it all for you. It's pretty cool, but it is a hit against Adobe. Adobe and Spotify, and then there was at least two or three other companies.
Microsoft.
Yeah, but I don't worry about Microsoft anymore. Microsoft's going to be, they're not doing anything interesting.
Azure? Not really.
Okay, I work for they're my competitor, but what is it why is that interesting other than putting price pressure on pricing?
Well, they're opening up their mobile services. You're starting to see them do a lot more, kind of making it more available.
No.
You're skeptical. Well, you work for Rackspace, so we can...
No, Google has a much better vision of the world than Microsoft. It all makes sense together, right? Microsoft, no.
Well, that seems to be like the underlying story they're not talking about, though, is, the Google Cloud Platform. Really, I really think they're going to bank on that quite a bit in trying to build up a developer community.
Well, we saw that with the new contextual APIs and several different APIs on geofences and stuff like that. They really were talking to the developers there and getting a little wonky geek wonky for a keynote where you have the world's press out. It's sort of interesting in hindsight. It's like, wow, I really did expect to see more from Motorola, more from Android, and more about Google Glass. What is the vision here? Why is Google doing this? I really thought that they would have a update of Glass here, and they didn't, which is telling that they're not going to be ready for this year. So they want to not apply hype to something that they're not ready to talk about. And they're getting enough PR already because people like me are wearing it in showers and stuff like that. But it was surprising. The lack of stuff talked about here was surprising.
But the sessions are pretty meaty. I mean, I counted up all the sessions.
But that's why people pay and come here, is to learn how to program the latest APIs. I'm just thinking through what we saw today. We saw new photos, new Google Plus.
Maps.
We saw new maps, which was pretty cool.
Chrome.
Yeah, but the Chrome stuff was like, okay.
Yeah.
Expected, incrementalism. It wasn't, here's a new thing that's like mind-blowing.
So what would you say?
We didn't see any mind-blowing stuff
yet. Yeah, we did not see any mind-blowing stuff today. But what do you think, what stood out the most then for you, if you're going to pick one or two things?
The voice search seemed to resonate the most with people. And then the new IDE resonated with this crowd, but not with the crowd at home. So that's the other thing is you got to remember there was a million people watching on YouTube at home, and then another 10 million or 50 million who are going to read like TechCrunch and
everything else,
all the other press here. There's 400 press here, it's pretty crazy. What else did they do? It's
not
amazing
much,
that 10 minutes after listening to 3 hours, it's hard to come up with.
Well, I think, Chrome, Android, the laptop, they talked a little about education, but it really wasn't really much.
There seemed to be a lot of fluffy moments. It's like, why is this 3 hours then? Just come out and boom, 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 and do 15 product announcements, let us go home.
A lot of focus, a lot of focus on media.
But I think they had other things to announce, and they just didn't make them. I think that's what, knowing how these big companies work, I think they were aiming at having other things out. Because having Larry just up on stage for how many minutes was he up there? 25
minutes?
Come on.
Yeah.
There was something scheduled for that time that we don't have this thing to announce. It doesn't work or whatever.
Yeah, I kept looking at my clock. I remember running out of time.
Yeah. I find their choices right now is interesting.
I think you're onto something with the contextual aspects of it because I think the Internet of Things.
For my book, that was
huge. If you're going to read the tea leaves, you can see, Google Glass. They're talking about, a lot about, voice APIs, translation APIs. They are kind of waiting for this sensor universe.
I tweeted that this was the Google contextual Google was being announced today. They didn't use the words context, but it was all over the place that certain voice searches are helped by knowing the context of why somebody's searching, i.e. where are they searching from? If you're searching from a shopping mall, it's different than searching from a ski resort, right? And they started showing you that on the maps, that they are understanding the context
right.
of where you are.
Right. How tall does my daughter have to be to ride, you know, the big roller coaster?
Right, because if you're doing that from Disneyland, or they use the boardwalk in Santa Cruz as an example, it should give you a completely different answer than if you're over here at the Yerba Buena Gardens, right? And so there was context all over the place. It's just that didn't add up to a really compelling TechCrunch article.
I'll get a few out
so we're here trying to figure out, what is the TechCrunch article? What's the headline of TechCrunch? Yeah. You know, Larry Page saying he doesn't like Scoble's shower scene. I mean, is that it?
Yeah, there you go.
Is that it?
That's it. We're going home. Thanks a lot, Robert.
Thanks.
Good to see you.
Thanks.